Hello, Ryan here, aka Mac, and welcome. So the schedule report has been updated, and on first sight, it does look a little disappointing with the latest burndown showing more bugs have arisen than been fixed. But this doesn't necessarily mean it's a bad thing. All the bugs that were fixed needed fixing, and these newly found bugs had to come about so that they can be fixed too. Just because there are now more than there was before doesn't mean that no bugs were fixed. This is just part and parcel of game development. You fix one bug, and then two more can rise up sometimes. So they are getting through them. And either way, all these bugs they do find still need to be fixed, otherwise the game won't work. Anyway, with that said, let's take a look at what is holding up 3.0 along with the newly completed features as well. So the holdups, let's start with them. They mentioned that they are relighting all the environments and ships to incorporate this improved lighting and fog tech. This is an ongoing task which will not hold up 3.0 but continue beyond Alpha 3.0. Mission givers are still getting some work and it is estimated to be ready on the 8th of September. The ship selector app and insurance claim UI has been set back slightly due to an extra debugging and support which is expected to be finished on the 4th of September. And the AI mission system used to create mission flows for missions like patrol, assassination, smuggling, etc. is currently under director review and is estimated to be ready around the 1st of September. So that is all the hold up so far. Now the newly ready content for the persistent universe content, the moons, surface outposts, additional surface outpost lighting, basic derelict ships, inhabited derelict ships. So I guess the basic AI functions that we saw at Levski, we can expect to see some of them on derelict sites populated as well, hoping the outposts as well, but nothing has been said there. Debris fields and Delamar and Levski, these are all now content complete and ready. In terms of gameplay, complete is the player man turrets, pick up and carry, item 2.0 conversion, and the item 2.0 includes operator seats, radar system, light control system, fuel, refuel, power supplies, pipes, and quantum travel. Insurance, stamina, cargo, commodities, doors and airlocks, kiosk support, atmospheric entry support, persistent damage, ammo and missiles, repair, inventory system support, rover and dragonfly in ships, IFCS performance improvements, and the hint system. All those gameplay features are complete as well. Pretty impressive there. For the core tech, they have the planetary tech, solar system tech, entity update component scheduler, and the entity owner manager complete. For UI, the kiosk UI, item 2.0 multifunction displays, field of view slider, personal manager app, mission manager app, and cargo manifest app, heavy armor for Star Marine, inventory system, mission board app, star map app, UI owner component, and the MobiGlass overhaul. They're all complete as well for the MobiGlass and UI in particular. For AI, the turrets are complete. In terms of graphics, the render to texture, environment probe, atmospheric entry, volumetric fog, GPU particle foundation, engine trails and contrails, asteroid physics, and exposure improvements are all done in terms of graphics. For the backend, the diffusion subset for 3.0 is complete. The solar system shop service and solar system mission service version 1, which is the mission broker, is also done. In terms of network, they've got a new message queue, physics serialization, and persistent data refactor. For ships and weapons, starting with ships, we've got the Drake Dragonfly, the Drake Cutlass Black, the RSI Constellation Aquila, the RSI Ursa Rover, the Mist Prospector, and the RSI Aurora. They're all complete, and in terms of weapons, the Bearing PASC, the Apocalypse Arms Scourge Railgun, Klaus and Werner Gallant Rifle, Arrowhead Sniper Rifle, the Kaysar Devastator 12 Shotgun, Klaus and Werner Arclight Pistol, Gemini L86 Pistol, and Bearing P4AR is also completely done. So quite a lot there has been complete and now implemented into the game, which could explain why we are seeing a lot more of these bugs rise up. So all these things needed to be finished, and in doing so, they've probably kicked up a couple more bugs here and there, which is why it looks so bad on paper. But in reality, they are getting through them. They need to get them all fixed regardless. So they're clearly making some great progress here, and fingers crossed we won't have to wait much longer. Thank you for watching. Do let me know what your thoughts are on this. Don't forget, courtesy of my patrons, every month we give away a Star Citizen starter package. So if you are not in the game yet, perfect for you to get in there. All you got to do is be subscribed to me here on YouTube and comment on any video throughout the month of September. Be sure to follow me on Twitch, Twitter, and Instagram, and I shall see you next time.